हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ प्रीतेश राउत एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट अ टर्बो प्रोप इंजन। इन अवर लास्ट लेक्चर और द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव टॉक अबाउट द टर्बोजेट इंजन। ओके, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टर्बो प्रोप इंजन। सो व्हाइल एक्सप्लेनिंग द टर्बो प्रोप इंजन, व्हाइल एक्सप्लेनिंग वर्किंग ऑफ टर्बो प्रोप इंजन, सो इट इज़ अगेन वर्क ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ न्यूटन्स सेकंड एंड थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन, सेम एज दैट ऑफ द टर्बोजेट इंजन। ओके, सो वर्किंग ऑपरेशन और द ऑपरेशन ऑफ वर्किंग इज सेम एज दैट ऑफ द टर्बोजेट इंजन, ओनली द प्रेजेंस ऑफ प्रोपेलर शाफ्ट इन द टर्बोप्रोप इंजन इट मेक्स अ डिफरेंस विद द टर्बोजेट इंजन। ओके, सो वॉट there is only one difference, that presence of the presence of the propeller shaft in the turboprop engine. Okay, so working principle will be the same. So now we will see the setup of the turboprop engine. So this is the setup of the turboprop engine. So that engine is consist of what? Propeller shaft, diffuser, compressor, combustion chamber and then nozzle. Okay, clear? And before that there is a turbine. So what in turbojet engine? Diffuser, compressor, combustion chamber, turbine and nozzle is there. Okay, so here in turboprop engine one more part is added, which is nothing but what? Propeller shaft. So what? So turboprop engine consists of propeller shaft, compressor, turbine, combustion chamber and then nozzle for the exhaust gases. Okay? So now we'll see the working of the turboprop engine. So it is also work on the open cycle gas turbine. Okay, so here we will see the function of the diffuser. So diffuser, it's a device which is placed in the front of the engine, okay, before the compressor. And the function of the diffuser is what? To slow down the incoming air. So when incoming air is, or we can say the atmospheric air when passes through the diffuser, which is the first device, when it passes through the diffuser, its kinetic energies get reduced and because of that there is a rise in pressure of that air. So when air is passed through the diffuser, its velocity get reduced and pressure will increase. Then that partially increased pressurized air then pass through the compressor, where its pressure is increases to a required pressure, and then it passes through the next device, that is nothing but what? Combustion chamber. When it bring to the combustion chamber, fuel is injected in the presence of that air and combustion is take place, and because of that combustion hot exhaust gases are generated or produced because of that combustion. Okay, because of that combustion the hot gases are produced, combustible gases are produced, and then that gases are then passes over the turbine blade where it expand partially, because here that exhaust gases, or we can say the combustible gases, are expanded in two times. First when it pass over the blade, and then when it pass through the nozzle. So two times that gases are expand, so partially they are expand when it passes over the turbine. So power is produced by the turbine, which is used for rotating the compressor shaft and other devices. Okay, so whatever the power which is produced by the turbine, which is used for the working of the compressor and other devices. Okay, so and thereafter that gases are passed through the nozzle. Okay, this is the tail portion of the engine. So when that gases are passes through the nozzle, its kinetic energy is increases and pressure is reduces. So when it passes through the, it forms a jet, and because of that jet and because of that high velocity jet at the exhaust, it provides reactive force to create forward propulsion or the thrust. So in this way, the forward propulsion or the thrust is produced because of the high velocity jet at the exhaust of the engine. Okay, so which will produce the reactive force, okay, to create the forward propulsion or the thrust. So in this turboprop engine, 80 to 90% of the thrust of the turboprop engine is produced by acceleration of the air outside the engine by the propeller, okay, and 10 to 20% of the thrust it is produced by the jet exit of the exhaust gas itself. Okay, now you will understand that 80 to 90% of the thrust which is produced by the turboprop engine by the acceleration of the air outside the engine by the propeller, and 10 to 20% of the thrust is produced by the jet exit of the exhaust gases. Okay, so this is the working of the turboprop engine. So there is a little bit difference in the turbojet and the turboprop is what? The presence of propeller shaft in the turboprop engine. Also, this turboprop engine, it is a very simple in design and having a lower vibrations, and also it occupy very small frontal area. It having very small frontal area, as well as its specific weight is also very low. So that's why this engine is better for what? For the small area, or we can say the small weight. For the small weight, again it finds the application in the helicopters, and also it is used for the various land and marine applications. Okay, so in this way we have discussed the turboprop engine, okay, and the turbojet engine. So when we differentiate this turbojet engine with the turboprop engine, there is a major difference is the presence of propeller shaft. Okay, and always remember that 80 to 90% of the thrust which is produced by the acceleration of air exhaust, okay, and the 10 to 20% of the thrust which is produced by the jet of the exhaust gas only. Okay, always remember. And the speed of that jet propulsion is limited by what? The propeller which is provided. So I hope you will understand that working of the turboprop engine. So thank you for listening the video. Thank you very much.